guys, we're going to work on strengthening our wrists and using it in tennis, and that's why I'm sitting here on a bucket, and I'm just going to show you how to use your wrist a little bit more in tennis, and you got to isolate it. So I'm not talking about your legs, I'm not talking about your shoulders, just your wrists. So you'll see tennis players, really good tennis players, they talk about the strength of the wrist. In fact, this is the reason why I'm making this is someone reached out to me, saw the video I had about the number one player in Colorado who's from Russia, talking about how he has strong wrists and how he was developing that with his players and things like that. So what I want to do is just show you a couple things you could do to strengthen your wrists. Now this could be for the forehand or backhand. I'm just going to show you the forehand side mainly. And the forehand side, we're working on just trying to come over the ball. And we're using our wrists to do that. Now, a lot of players say use their wrists, they use it and they jerk, and you see how I jerk to a stop like that? That's how you hurt your wrists. So you gotta let the wrists come over the ball, right? But then you gotta release the tension. So if you have tension after you're done swinging through the ball, you're doing it wrong. So what I mean by that is you should be able to come to a stop and relax as the ball's coming over. So I'm gonna come over and I'm relaxing as I do that after I initiate the force to move the racket head over the ball. So it's super important to relax at the end. All right, no jerking. Also, you'll realize that I have to make sure that my racket head is below my handle. So if I'm up here, that means I have a pretty tight grip, and also I'm gonna hit the top of the ball, it's gonna go right into the net. You gotta learn to drop your racket head. This is a very common thing for backhands. A lot of players do not drop the racket. You'll watch Djokovic, who has one of the best backhands in the world, two-handed backhand. His left wrist drops under the ball so he can come over the ball and hit with a lot of spin. So we do that a little bit better with the right hand, but the left hand does the same thing. So what I'm gonna do is just show you, you gotta drop the racket head. See how I came under the ball to lift over it, okay? Very important. Last thing you wanna look for is make sure you have forward spin. So the ball needs to have forward spin when you're hitting. So I did a lesson yesterday with someone and saw that they were having some side spin on their forehand. Tells me everything. Tells me they're coming across the ball, probably with tension as well. Side spin does not give you control on a ground stroke, so you wanna make sure you're coming over the ball. So I'm gonna make sure that ball has forward spin when I watch it come off my racket. So when you're doing this, make sure you're watching too. So you're feeling the sensation of relaxation after you hit the ball, and you're watching the ball with spin, okay? Another thing you could do to strengthen your forearm and your wrist, because forearm is part of that, is you'll see like Roger Federer, his arms are super small, right? His biceps, but his forearms are huge, right? So the idea is having strong forearms and biceps are important. So all you need is a PVC pipe, really cheap, some string or rope, and then something heavy at the top, or something kind of heavy. So this is a water bottle filled with water, and all I'm gonna do is lift up waist high, and then I'm just gonna start twisting with my hands to make the rope go up and bring the water bottle up. So all I'm doing is just making sure I'm twisting my wrists and my forearms. I'm locking my arms very straight, and then I'm just gonna simply let it go back down. So you can adjust this. You can use a gallon of water if you'd like and just fill up that water with as much water as you need to make the weight challenging, but you're able to do that a few reps and feel like you can isolate your forearms and your wrists. So you can see that I'm really twisting the forearm and the wrists, and I'm really making sure that I'm strengthening it as well. So the idea though is if you do that, you gotta make sure that when you're swinging through the ball, you're not using tension after you swing, because that's tennis elbow. You're gonna overwork your forearms, because the idea a lot of players do already is they overwork their forearms because they have so much tension in their swing. So you gotta make sure when you finish, you're relaxing at the end. So try those exercises out, and hopefully that'll get your wrists a little stronger. Good luck.